Okay, gang, this is Transformation Thursday, and all week you've been seeing panels that have to do with perseverance. Carol happens to be a very dear friend that's on here, and I know personally, Carol, that you have faced different adversities, and you find ways to the mountains in front of you. I've seen you go around it, over it, and try to go under it. You go after whatever it takes, because you actually know this is real life, right? So I just appreciate, so Transformation Thursday, none of us will have transformation unless we figure out how to overcome every mountain that gets thrown in front of us on our journey, right? So what is your thoughts to our 55 plus family? Because you're on the journey just like the rest of us. What are your thoughts on how you persevere through some of the stuff?
I think it's a constant redirect. It's you find success, you're on that track for, it could be a long while, it could be a short while, and then that doesn't work all of a sudden, whether it's just something in your body, if it's an injury, if it's, you know, someone in your family requires a different side of you, and you have to come up with what the next plan is. And it's not always easy. I think it's constant though. I can't ever imagine getting to a place where I'm like, ta-da, I'm done. Like, you know, it's not going to happen. So it's good. I was laughing today. I was listening to somebody posted a YouTube video that I thought, oh, that looks interesting. And the more I listened to it, that was exactly what it was on. And I thought, I need like a tattoo that says redirect on my forehead, you know? So you think, okay, I've hit a mountain, or I've hit a roadblock. What am I going to do? I'm going to figure out the next step. And I've had food journey next steps. I was about 65 pounds heavier than I am now. And I've been 50 pounds lighter than I am now. And I just, it's constantly trying to figure out what the next step is. And COVID happened, and I didn't realize that my entire family is going to move back in with me and I have to cook for everybody all over again. Or, oh, I had double knee replacements, not at the same time, but 6 months apart, but that took rehab, but it launched me into this physical place that I never thought I could do, you know. And then to find DDPY, I had been in a car accident, and somebody had rear-ended me, and the seatbelt had just did a number on my shoulder, and it was hard. So I was in physical therapy, and the physical therapist said to me, you know, now's the time you got to decide how you're going to age. Where is this going to go? And I had seen DDPY, watched Arthur's video. It looked like something that would be great, but I just hadn't committed to it. And I thought, okay, I can do that. Like, I can start. And I started with, you know, I had the chair next to me. I had to rely on other things. And it didn't feel, that wasn't the person I wanted to be. I wanted to be strong and self-reliant. It's humbling. You know, you think, I can't get up off the floor, or I can't do these things. And now, you know, for me, the key is consistency for that. And, you know, the light bulb goes off in my head that it's probably consistency for everything in life for me that makes a difference. But just getting up, I get up every morning at 5 before I go to work. I work, you know, a full day. I commute about an hour each way, 45 minutes each way. And I do my DDPY. I do anything from, some mornings it's a blue level and I'm just really going into the basics. Most mornings it's probably a yellow. Some mornings I get daring and I do the whatever's between the reddish level with the orange. And it's great. But there's still things I can't do. I can't do a push-up, and it's my shoulder. You know, one of them's bad, but the other one's pretty bad too. But I can hold an alligator plank. So the minute somebody says we're going to do 2-3 DDPY pushups, I'm thinking, okay, I can do a 60-second alligator plank, or I can do a plank, or I can do wall pushups, or I have to make it. I definitely have to make it my own. It is humbling, but you do it, right? And if every morning I can burn over 300 calories in 35, 40 minutes, and I do that every day, it's just not even a thought now. I do it. So I don't know. That's the exercise wise right now. It's not a redirect, but food is where I just it's a constant deciding, okay, what's next?
Well, you know, the redirect idea, I love that too, because that fits in completely with perseverance, right? Because you're going down the happy road where you think you know everything that you're facing, right? You know where the aches are, where are the modifications, and then you get thrown a new one, right? And
Yep.
you're like, what? But when you're thinking redirect, it's like, okay, so now I shift this way and I go a little bit more that direction, right?
Yeah. And you have to stop. I mean, you've done it. I've talked to you about things, journeys you've been on where unexpected things, you were such a great caregiver to your mom, but then afterwards you're like, okay, starting over again.
I have 58 days with no sleep, and I'll guarantee you when she finally passed, which is beautiful because she passed in my arms, it was, I gave her everything I had for 58 days, right? And it was a beautiful goodbye to a best friend and a sweet mother, right? But wow, on the other side of that, it's like I wake up one morning and I'm, after I slept 3 straight days almost, right? I wake up and I'm like, okay, now we are starting over in a different phase. And it is how quickly we can shift. Like I shared with you just before we started, I was on my trike the other morning and pulled some kind of muscle on the backside of my knee. And I'm like, what is this? Never had that like ever happen to me, right? But it's like, okay, it is what it is. Now you shift. But it's being prepared for those things, right? And those seasons where we have maybe a loved one we're caring for whatever reason, they're going through something. Now we shift to caring for them, maybe in a hospital or whatever. But we have to find a way. We have to find a way to still come back center, even if we give ourselves the grace period of some time. You knew full well
Right.
I was doing
And
some,
I, no, go ahead.
no, you, but you know, I was
Oh.
doing things with DDPY, but not to the level. Sometimes you go through the motions and your heart isn't in it at all. You're just doing it. And I was just doing it. I was staying consistent, but my heart wasn't in it because I was trying to find my bearings again. But it's okay
And
if
now
that way.
we see you with your trike and your smile, and it's and that part of you's back, and but you do have to. I look at the progress though. We never, I don't think we ever go all the way back.
No.
Sometime you either have a level of knowledge. I remember when I first started working on what I was eating, and I still had young kids at home, and it was chaos. It's just the normal chaos, nothing horrible, but I wasn't eating right, and there was a lot of sugar in our food, and I wasn't eating vegetables like I and now my food, the type of food I eat, is totally transformed. So even though I can say, oh, I want to lose more weight, I wouldn't change that at all. I'm so happy with where we are that way, and the food I buy and stuff like that. Now it's just a different focus. And I think if anybody says that they've conquered it, you cross your fingers and hope that that's true, but it's not always true.
I was reading in a book, it was early this morning or yesterday, about historically the average person would go through we would consume 10 pounds of sugar a year, historically. Right now, and I forget the exact number, but it was something like 250 10-pound things that the
Oh
average
my
American
gosh.
right now, sugar, but they put sugar in everything, right? That's why I don't even use ketchup because I know they hide sugar in that. I mean, all these places they hide the sugar, right? McDonald's French fries that I used to eat, now many reasons not to eat them, but also they actually put sugar in that around them. And no wonder they were my favorite because they had sugar on them, right? And you get so addicted.
You do, and I think you there's a, I don't want to generalize because we're not all in the same boat, but if we have been on this journey a while, there's a feeling of how come everybody else can eat it? How come everybody else can, am I just missing that map? Like every, we've talked about people who take the hard road and the easy road, and I feel like it's constantly trying to figure out a code that everyone else has and I don't sometimes. But it's chipping away at it. It's just hoping that, that you can make a little bit of a difference. There's no magic potion.
Yep. And it is specifically the food journey. The further I go down the road, the more I figure out, oh, that was really good. I mean, walking away from gluten and sugar was a decision that immediately changed my gut health and energy, kind of everything, right? But fine-tuning beyond that, there are foods that my body seriously doesn't want. And so it's like, oh, you didn't like that one? Okay. So it is. We are on journeys together, sweet friend. And I just appreciate, I want people to follow you, and if they have questions, reach out to you, because you are about as transparent, Carol, and real as they get. So, do you have any closing thoughts you want to tell our 55 plus family before we end?
I love the whole group because I think I like you said, this is me. You get what I'm happy to share what's real. And I love the fact that there's so many people out there that are doing the same thing. We're never gonna get totally there, but we'll all go on the journey together.
Exactly. And we have the high athletic, and we have the ones that are really just trying to use their walker, someday get to a cane, and everything in between is such a joy. It is such a joy. And we are growing like crazy. It's such a joy to see that happen too, right? Obviously, Steve, you and Dallas are happy that we're all finding a space together. This was their vision, and it's happening. We find great comfort in talking to each other in our group. So
Yeah, people want to get older. They want to be with us.
there's a lot of people that try to come in that, and of course I have to say, no, sorry, I can't let you in. But yeah, there's a lot of beggars, and they get creative. Like, no, you don't understand him. I'm 40, but I feel 60. I'm like, great, but we can't let you in. So there is a rule. What can we say? So, well, bless you, sweet friend. Thank you for coming on and sharing your journey. I hope you guys all reach out to Carol. She's pretty special. So have a wonderful Thursday, everybody. Love you tons.
Thanks, Pam.
Thank you.